Hello friends, in my this video, I am going to discuss bioimpedance sensor working principle, okay? So from the name itself, you can get an idea what is the working principle based on this. So bioimpedance sensor, you can classify this name into three parts. Sensor means it will measure something and it will convert into electrical energy as output, right? Now, impedance means something related with either resistor or capacitor or inductor, right? And bio means related to body, okay? So, basically, in this sensor, so what is the working principle of the bioimpedance sensor? From the name itself, you can conclude that this is such kind of sensor which will basically use the electrical property of body and it will measure something, okay? So what is that? Let us try to understand. So human body, there are mainly electrical properties. If you consider, the main electrical properties are resistive property and capacitive property. Based on the capacitive property, different sensors like touch sensors, like touch screen, whatever we use, that is made based on capacitive property of the human body. And the resistor property is mainly used also. And based on the capacitive property, Electroboom has already uploaded one very nice video. I'll post the link in the description also. If you want to check, you can check there, okay? Actually, the man is like a pioneer of electronics or electrical domain. And he has made such kind of interesting and cool videos based on this electronics related concepts. So really this is appreciable. So you can check if you want to know about something in detail or practical about the capacitive property of the body. I will post the link in the description. Anyway, so the bioimpedance sensor, if you consider, so see what is the working principle. That suppose this is human body. Already I am telling that I am not good in drawing. So if you consider this as human body lower part, then what we do? We connect two electrodes which will be situated with a distance suppose D. You just consider like this. So what will happen? Then we flow small amount of AC current through these two electrodes, and you know human body is conductive, right? So what will happen? The blood flowing through different venous or arteries will conduct the electricity, and from this electrode, if the small amount of AC current enters, from this electrode this current will come out. And here this is signal processing device or signal conditioning circuit which will measure the resistance of the part of the body. And if suppose the blood flowing through the venous or arteries changes, what will happen? Obviously the impedance of the path in between these two electrodes will also change, so that you can get the impedance variation with respect to temperature. Like suppose in the y-axis impedance is plotted with respect to temperature, then if there is some variation in the impedance, that means then what happens, that is the amount of blood flowing through the blood vessel is basically changes, okay? As a result, what will happen, that the impedance changes. So from the impedance change graph, we can get an idea about the change in the amount of blood flow through the arteries or through venous, okay? So this is how this bioimpedance sensor works. Bio means it is related to body. Sensor means it is converting, measuring something and converting that data into electrical signal. Like here, what is happening? The amount of change in amount of the blood flow through the blood vessels is basically converted into impedance characteristics. This is one, so that it is called sensor. And why impedance? Because it is using the impedance property of the body. Okay, now these things are clear. Obviously, we cannot apply high AC voltage, that means very high voltage, we cannot apply. Now, there you may ask one question, what kind of AC voltage we can use? There are two AC voltage, one is low, another one is high, right? So, obviously, it is preferable to use high AC voltage, and also that is for a very small span of time, not for a very long duration, otherwise it may be dangerous also. So intuitively you can understand the reason very easily. Suppose you just consider from t equal to 0 to suppose t equal to 5 seconds, you are applying low AC, low frequency signal as well as high frequency signal of same amplitude. See, the low frequency signal is remaining at the high voltage comparatively more time compared to the high frequency AC voltage. Or you can think like this also. Suppose you are considering this particular time span from t equal to 0 to suppose t equal to 5 seconds, then it is arising at t at a 0 volt at only 4 points, but here it will arise 0 volt at lots of point in the high frequency case. Okay, so see, these are all the points where the AC voltage is coming as 0. Okay, so that obviously we use high frequency AC signal, and that is obviously of small amplitude and for a small time. Okay, we use this so that this device can operate safely, okay, on human body. Okay, so this is the frequency of operation idea. And one more thing, you may be curious about what kind of diseases can be detected from the change in amount of blood flow through a blood vessel. So you can easily understand, one is this one. Okay, due to what happens, that due to smoking or high cholesterol, suppose this is your original blood vessel inside view. Now suppose you are due to smoking or high cholesterol, what happens, a thick layer of fat just accumulates inside the layer of blood vessel. So as a result, what will happen, the amount of the volume of blood flow through the vessels will basically decrease. So we can get an idea about this problem or this disease also. Okay, so this disease is called, in terms of medical science term, it is called artery. So artery means this is related to these arteries, artery sclerosis. Okay, so this is one application. Another one is deep venous thrombosis. What is thrombosis? You may know from the concept of life science, whatever you have studied in your class 10 or school level science, that is formation of blood clot within blood vessel. So if blood clot formation is there within blood vessel, obviously the volume of the blood flowing through the blood vessel or venous or arteries, what will it will change? So as a result, impedance will change, and from the change in impedance, the formation of blood clot, we can get an idea. Okay, so there may be different application in medical science, I don't know much about them, but the basic operation is like this. So this is very important bioimpedance sensor. This may come as a question in your sensor and instrumentation or sensor and measurement course in your electronics and communication engineering. So just try to understand the principle right in your own way. Okay, don't try to memorize the language. You can write by your own, you should understand the story. Okay, so this is all for my this video. If you have any doubt, you can ask in the comment section. Thank you for watching.